School board members in Nash County voted to delay the move to face-to-face learning until January 25th. This was originally set to begin January 11th. Leaders say they did it because of COVID-19 cases in the area. Right now, the district says there are 166 staff members and students quarantined at home.
The approval of the second stimulus package is providing more than just hope for many this holiday season. It's also providing millions of dollars of funding right here in North Carolina. CBS 17's Holden Kowicki joins us live in Raleigh to explain how quickly we could see a difference in our check. Holden.
Well, Marius, that $600 stimulus check could be in your bank account as soon as next week. But the biggest news here might be that 11-week extension of unemployment benefits that is really, you know, was set to run out on Saturday.
We're seeing some light at the end of the tunnel.
Since the start of the pandemic, Chris Keener hasn't been able to secure more than part-time work.
It's been tough, you know. It's been touch and go for us.
He's been able to collect unemployment, but while he waited for his claim to be processed, the bills piled up.
It was like 7 or 8 weeks for our benefits to even kick in.
Now he's hoping that help is on the way after the federal government added a $300 a week bonus to his benefits for the next 11 weeks. But he's already questioning if that will be enough.
I think they may have waited a little bit too long. The damage is already done.
In addition to assistance for the unemployed, the second stimulus allows cash-strapped businesses to write off federal funding and forgives payroll protection loans up to $150,000.
We need to provide help to businesses, to households, so when we get on the other side of this pandemic, we have an economy left.
NC State economist Mike Walden says the move was necessary, but it creates another issue for a country that's added $5 trillion in debt during the pandemic.
We do need to realize there is a payment day. We are going to have to be devoting more of our budget to financing the national debt. It'll probably mean at some point higher taxes.
It'll help some folks. Could it be a little better? Sure. Would we rather have work come back instead? Absolutely.
I wouldn't be surprised to certainly see at least pushes for another round of stimulus money.
If you need a little more good news, Walden says he sees the economy getting back to pre-COVID levels early in 2021. Now, if you'd like to see a full breakdown of where all of that stimulus money is going, just go to our website, cbs17.com. Reporting live in Raleigh, Holden Kowicki, CBS 17 News.